If you're looking for a faster way to get all of your products into Shopify, then you've come to the right place. I'm Manuela with Plytix, the central source of truth for all of your product information. In this video, I'm going to show you how to import a CSV sheet into your Shopify account. This is especially important when you have a catalog with a lot of products, or if you're moving from a different platform like WooCommerce or Magento. Now, in theory, importing a CSV sheet is simple. You just head to the product section, click import, choose the file you want to upload, and your product should import, right? Sure, it's simple when you're adding Shopify's pre-formatted template, but when you're adding your own products, it's a whole nother story. A lot of times you'll see the message products imported when in reality, no products have actually been imported. It's not until you go to your email account that you'll see that your products didn't import due to errors in the CSV sheet. The steps I'm going to show you will help you set up your CSV correctly so you can import your products into your Shopify account without getting these errors. Now, the first step is to understand what data can be imported into Shopify via a CSV and how it should be formatted. The easiest way to get your CSV sheet ready is to take a look at the sample template that Shopify provides. I'll link this template in the description below, or you can download it directly from Shopify's Help Center. Now, some of the fields on this template are required and need to have a valid value. Some are required but can be left blank, meaning you need the column header, but you don't have to add values to it. And some of them are optional, meaning you don't need to include them in the CSV you plan to import into Shopify. To get a better understanding of which is which, Shopify provides this guide with examples of all the fields you can import. I'll link this in the description of this video. You can use this template as a framework for your own products. Now, if your product data is stored in different spreadsheets and systems, then you'll need to either create a new CSV sheet with all the fields that Shopify requires, or you can copy all that data over into the template that Shopify provides. Just remember to delete the sample products in that template first. Rather than having data in different spreadsheets and systems, I recommend storing your products in a product information management or PIM platform. My product information is stored in Plytix, which makes finding and managing all my product data a breeze because it keeps it all in one place and ready to be distributed. Quick side note, Plytix does have a direct integration with Shopify as part of their paid plan, which automates everything that I'm gonna show you in this video. But if you're not ready for a paid plan just yet, that's okay. You can still get your data into Shopify with the free plan. It'll just require some manual workarounds, which we'll get to, and some manual maintenance. But this would still be less work than if you had your data stored in spreadsheets and had to manually extract all of that information. So let me show you how that would work. What you see here is the product overview of a Plytix PIM account. All your product information can be seen in this table. Similar to a spreadsheet, the rows are products, and these columns show attributes or pieces of data about your product, for example, size, price, or even digital assets like hero image. Before we're able to import this data into Shopify, we first want to make sure that our product information is formatted correctly and that there are no missing fields. This will keep us from getting the errors I mentioned earlier or from accidentally deleting any information for products that are already in your Shopify store. To do that, I've created a table that includes these fields or attributes that are in the Shopify template. I've also added a completeness tracker, which gives me a quick glance into whether or not my product has all the information it needs to be uploaded into Shopify. This way, I can get a more visual look into what data is missing. I'll drop a link in the description below where you can learn more about creating and using completeness attributes. Before we begin, let's look over how to set up your data so that it can be imported into Shopify without hitting any snags. Let's first look at how your products are set up. The way you set up your products is up to you and what you feel is best for your business. Now, some marketplaces and platforms require you to have a non-sellable parent product with sellable children products. Shopify, however, is the opposite and requires all products to be sellable products. If you do have your product set up with a non-sellable parent, that is totally okay. We actually recommend having it this way because you can quickly filter out the non-sellable parent products and get a list of only the variant products like this. This is easier than later adding a non-sellable parent product if you decide to expand to a new marketplace that requires it. Now let's look at some of the fields that Shopify asks for. The handle is the unique name for each product. This field is necessary when importing a CSV because it tells Shopify if it should create a product in your store or if it should update a product that's already existing in your store. Because the handle is in the URL of your product, it has specific requirements. It can include letters, dashes, and numbers, but it cannot include spaces or other characters. So for example, the product Dear XL Sweatshirt should have the handle Dear-XL-Sweatshirt with no spaces. If you don't have this set up correctly, I will show you how to change it in bulk after we export. When a product comes in different variations, say different colors or different sizes, then the handle needs to be the same for each of the product variations. You'll define the differences by adding values to the options columns. Take this product, for example. This sweatshirt comes in different colors and sizes. I'll group them together with the same handle, and to list the options or the variations, I'll put the option type under option one name, in this case, color, and option one value, I'll add the color options, which in this case are white and sports gray. Since this product also has a second type of variation, I'll use the option two fields as well. So under option two name, I'll write size, and under option two value, I'll list the different sizes, small, medium, large, extra large, so on. If a product doesn't have any variations, you'll still need to define the option one fields. So for option one name, you should write title, and for option one value, you should write default title. Leaving this blank will cause your products to not upload correctly or at all. Other fields to keep in mind are the variant grams field. This one refers to the weight of the product in grams, and you must enter a value here even if that value is zero. Variant inventory policy, which defines whether to continue selling a product or to deny the purchase of the product whose inventory has reached zero. There's variant fulfillment service. You can see the valid values for this on the Shopify Help Center that I linked below. If you have a custom fulfillment service, then you'll need to add the name of that service to your Shopify's admin section before you import this CSV into your account. If not, you'll just end up getting an error and your products won't import. To do this, head to Settings, then go to Shipping and Delivery, and in the Custom Order Fulfillment, add the fulfillment service name. Next up, we have Image SRC. This allows you to add the URL of an image. Be aware that you can only have one image URL per cell. So if you want to add more than one image to a product, you'll need to add additional rows once we export this data into a CSV. I'll show you how to do that once we complete the exporting process. Also, it's important to know that the URLs you add to this column won't be variant specific, which brings us to the variant image column. The variant image column allows you to add an image that's specific to a variant product. Shopify only allows one featured image per variant, so you should only have one URL per product in this column. Status. This will let Shopify know if you want to make the product available for purchase or not yet. Last but not least, price. You'll need to list the price for each product. If you want to add additional data like description or discounted price, then you are more than welcome to do so. Just make sure you follow this template and add the information to its corresponding column. Now that we've gone over the important fields, you'll need to gather your data. If you have this stored in different spreadsheets, you'll need to copy it over to the Shopify template. If you're using Plytix PIM's free plan, then you would just select the products you want to export. In my case, it'll be the products that are in my Shopify ready list. Choose CSV, and choose the field you want to export from your Plytix account. I've actually saved the ones that I need to an attribute group called Shopify to save time when I'm exporting. To see how you can skip this step, stay tuned until the end and I'll show you how quickly you can get information from Plytix to your Shopify store using Plytix's direct integration. All right, now that you have your CSV, it is ready to import into Shopify. Just drag that sheet over to the importer and click upload and continue. Here you can see a preview of your product. If something doesn't look right or if your headers weren't the same name as the ones on the Shopify template, you can click change the order of the column headings to match columns to fields. Here we see that my thumbnail column was ignored. So I'll match it to the variant image field and save the column heading. Now I can click on import products and voila, my products are now in Shopify. If you need to do some modifications like creating handles or adding images, then let's open up your spreadsheets before we import it into Shopify. Like I mentioned before, to create the handles, you can duplicate your product title or product label column. Highlight the new column, then under the help tab right here, type in find and replace. Under find, you'll put a space and on the replace field, add a dash. Then click replace all. Now you can rename the duplicated column header to handle. If you want to add more images to a product, you find that product column in your sheet, insert a new row below it, copy the handle and the variant SKU if it has one to the new row, and then you can add the new image URL to the image column like this. Now, if you want to save yourself the trouble of doing all this manual work of copying data over or exporting it into a CSV, creating handles or adding rows for images, then you can use Plytix's direct integration to Shopify. With the integration, all you do is map Plytix attributes to Shopify fields once. You can add entire galleries by mapping just one field. And what's more, you can schedule automatic updates so that your Shopify store is always up to date with the latest product information. If you want to get started with a free PIM, then click on the link in the description below and let me know in the comments what you'd like to see next. And we're always coming out with new content on how to grow and streamline your e-commerce business, so make sure you subscribe.